This is Radio Bailrigg at Lancaster University, which is about to make history by becoming the first student radio station to gain a permanent FM licence.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to your brand new radio station, Bailrigg FM. It's 6 p.m. on Friday the 19th of January, 1996.
I see Radio Bailrigg as providing general entertainment and information for the students and staff of the university here. Our transition to FM has allowed us to broadcast to staff as well as the students, and hopefully we'll be able to sustain the listenership that we've had for the last few days, having just started.
Yeah, well, compared to a commercial radio station, Radio Bailrigg's certainly really different. And the output we have here is key to the specific audience on campus. Campus News is a specifically good example. And also programmes that like competitions and quizzes and news features and this sort of thing, which we usually put on around tea time. And then, of course, the request show, which other radio stations, they might do request shows, but they're not targeted in the same way as ours are. Ours unusually are between 11 at night and 1 in the morning. And that's a time when most radio stations will be winding down for the night. But on campus, after all the bars shut, we find that's our most popular slot. And particularly on FM, we seem to get quite a lot of listeners for that programme.
I remember in the first year, they used to have a request show, which went down really well. I remember in the blocks, finesse, people used to run around trying to like get the requests and stuff. That worked really well, but I don't know whether they still do it, I'm not sure. Do they?
I like the request shows, because the request shows.
The request show, the music you want to hear on 87.7 Bailrigg FM. Call 3902. All radio stations have a potential audience from which a certain segment is targeted. There is interaction between the target audience and the station, as the station tries to cater for the particular tastes of that audience, whilst the audience chooses a particular style of station.
We've got a lot of talent around here. People who like to do jazz, indie, rock, a lot of different styles like that. But we're also aiming at the mainstream market, perhaps at the staff, because staff, for the first time, are able to pick us up in their offices. We're aiming at everybody on campus. We're able to do this more better than other stations because we do have the market built in for us here.
No, I don't know, really, but Radio Bailrigg is sort of like, it's just basically fun, isn't it? And entertainment.
Yeah.
It's not that serious, and
I think it tries to aim everyone.
Yeah.
I personally don't think that having staff listening will make the blind bit of difference to any of the presenters. They're going to play whatever they want. It would be nice to have some staff tune in. A lot of staff around here are research associates. They're not like fuddy-duddy lecturers with small beards and round glasses.
This policy of targeting applies to student radio, public service radio, and independent commercial radio. One of the independent stations which can be heard in Lancaster is Radio Wave, which broadcasts from Blackpool.
Well, Blackpool needed its own radio station because of the type of people that are here. They're so different from the global area that was already served by independent radio. Blackpool's unique with the style of area that it is, and that's why I believe Blackpool needed its own local radio station. Well, we aim for the whole of the resident audience of Blackpool, and we also like to offer a service for the transient population. Obviously, there's 320,000 people that live across the Fylde Coast, but there's some 14 million visitors, so the service that we offer, or the type of music and programming that we give, is mainly, primarily going out to the local audience, but it's also has some part of it aimed at the transient population as well.
Any identity of any radio station has got to take into account the people it broadcasts to. So at Radio Wave, we wouldn't particularly adopt an aggressive stance because we broadcast to people who wouldn't particularly like that idea. So there aren't any zaps and crashes and particularly overtly pop-style ways of doing things at Radio Wave. We present things in a very friendly manner, that we believe our listeners will appreciate. We're a family radio station, first and foremost, and everything that we do, we like to feel would appeal to all members of the family, whatever age group they are.
But radio wave, I think it's aimed at, like, younger people, you know.
Well, it can be for all different age groups, really, because it's all different types of music.
It's really like a family. It's for all ages, really.
I think it's aimed more like at, 18 to 20, because, I mean, you've got people who are at college and that, and people at school don't get to listen to, like, the jukebox.
And I think radio is very much like a light. You would transmit a narrow beam if you were a specific type of audience or a specific type of music that you're playing. But we go for a very wide angle beam to catch a much wider audience, and that's why our music is quite varied and diverse, and our information about related activities going on in the area are also quite wide.
A radio station's relationship with its audience is complemented by the presenters, who adopt their own personal style.
Well, obviously, each presenter tries to produce their own identity, something that they can be identified by as to the listeners. I use my name a lot. My full name is rather a mouthful, so I just tend to call myself Cameron instead of Cameron Patterson, because it's got an awful lot of syllables in it. So I think using my first name gives the listeners something to latch on to.
A personal identity for any newsreader, I suppose, would be that of being a serious newsreader. Professionalism, of course, is the utmost, and the impartiality of being a newsreader is, of course, the key to the job.
In the past, I've done many lunchtime programmes, and unfortunately, I seem to have this image as a nice presenter. Everything's nice radio. And that means competitions, things like the hits and headlines competition, where you have to guess the year from a set of headlines and a few hits. It's not very original, but that comes up quite often. And catchphrases like, this is 87.7 Bailrigg FM while you munch your lunch. And I get the mickey taken out of me for things like that quite often.
James Malcolm.
You need to put your pants back on, honey.
Coming up now then, we have that good old game that is called the Lyric Game. You give me a ring, extension 3902. I tell you some lyrics before you give me a ring. And then you see whether or not you can tell me what song I'm talking about and who the artist is, perchance. This artist is a real rascal. These are the lyrics. We just met. And I know I'm a bit too intimate. But something huge is coming up. Ed, and yes, that's probably my dinner. And we're both included. What song do those lyrics come from?
Shell's identity is just a bit of everything, really.
I don't really know. It's just sort of like Chris Evans, but with women. We try to make the music of the show appeal to the student audience.
We have requests where we get people to phone in about certain subjects and things that we're discussing.
Mm. And the things that we talk about are things that have happened to us on campus, and things that other students can relate to as well, like sharing a kitchen and meeting people from different countries as well, which is quite interesting.
You have to be there.
What are we up for next?
Up for next is, you'll have to mention about his rabbit.
And then we'll do the home and away, and then we'll play a record.
Home and away? Who am I doing? Am I doing, can I do day, mate?
Yeah, it's just a crap joke.
Right, anyway, that's a crap joke.
Radio, you're speaking to your listener. That's the way that it works in the business. You're told to speak to your listener. I think it's much more personal, and you get better pictures on the radio, which is something which is also said.
As Radio Wave is a commercial radio station, its revenue is reliant upon companies purchasing advertising airtime. This also applies to Radio Bailrigg, although not to the same degree.
Student radio is really different to commercial radio. For a start, we don't play that many commercials. We get our funding through the student union mostly, although we do have to make our own money through nightclubs that we've organised over the last few years. And also by playing adverts on the radio. We have certain programmes sponsored and we also play adverts.
Being commercial, you're able to support and develop the local businesses within your community.